Students, let's start solving the example on textbook page number 71. Neha took a loan of 50,000 rupees at 12 PCPA to buy a two-wheeler. So there is one girl whose name is Neha. She took a loan of rupees 50,000 at the rate of 12 PCPA to buy a two-wheeler. What amount will she return to the bank at the end of 1 year? Okay, so how much amount does she have to pay to the bank after 1 year? This is what we are asked to solve. Dear students, first of all, let us come to know the basic thing before we start solving this example. Always remember, amount is equal to principal plus interest. Interest is the amount which we have to pay in exchange of the money taken from the bank, or sometimes when we save the money in the bank gives us interest. Sometimes when we take money from bank in terms of loan, so that time also we have to pay certain interest. But when we return the amount to the bank, that time we have to pay the actual amount taken from the bank. That time it is called as the principal, and the interest which we have to pay in terms of we are taking. Okay, so that total becomes amount. So finally, amount is equal to principal plus interest. Let's start solving this example. Neha took a loan of 50,000 rupees at 12 PCPA to buy a two-wheeler. What amount will she return to the bank at the end of 1 year? When it is said PCPA, that means it is for 100 rupees. So here the rate of interest is 12 PCPA. So rupees 12 is the interest to be paid on rupees 100. That you have to remember. PCPA means it is applied on rupees 100, and we have to find out how much interest does Neha have to pay on 50,000 rupees. Clear? Let us consider X be the interest on rupees 50,000, and it is already given 12 PCPA. Now 12 PCPA is the interest rupees 12 paid on rupees 100. Now to solve this example, we will compare the both conditions. Okay, we have considered X on rupees 50,000 and rupees 12 is already given for rupees 100. X upon 50,000 is equal to 12 upon 100. Now why we can consider this? Why can we compare? For rupees 100, it was 12. 12 rupees is the interest on each rupees 100. Okay. So we are asked to find out the interest on rupees 50,000. Therefore, X upon 50,000 is equal to 12 upon 100. To find out the value of X, we will cross multiply 50,000 and 12 divided by 100. Therefore, X is equal to 12 multiplied by 50,000 upon 100 is equal to 2 zeros from the denominator will cross out with 2 zeros of numerator from the value of 50,000. Remaining value comes 500 multiplied with 12. So 12 5 is 60. 60 with 2 more zeros. So final answer is 6,000. Okay. Value of X is 6,000. Now what is X? X we have considered as interest on rupees 50,000. And we are asked to find out how much amount does Neha has to pay for the bank at the end of 1 year. We have here found out the value of interest. The interest is rupees 6,000. Therefore, amount is equal to principal plus interest. Principal is 50,000. Interest has become 6,000. So final amount when Neha has to pay to the bank, when she has to return the entire amount to the bank, is total 56,000. It is not that only interest Neha will pay to the bank. Okay. When she is taking 50,000 from bank, she has to pay that 50,000 also, including the interest. Interest is like the amount which she has to pay since bank has given to the money, like how we keep the person for the rent. We keep a person for 1 month at a rent and we ask some amount to be paid, right? We ask for 2,000, we ask for 3,000. Same way, it is like a rent asked by the bank in exchange with the money given to the particular person. Okay, so the final amount Neha has to pay to the bank is rupees 56,000. Next example from textbook page number 72. Now students, we came to know how to find out the amount. Amount is equal to interest plus principal. Always remember the formula to find out interest. PRT upon 100. Multiplication of three terms principal. T means time, R means rate of interest, and P means principal. Okay, upon 100. I is indicated as interest, P is indicated as principal, T is indicated as time, and R is indicated as rate of interest. Okay, now T knows sometimes it is written as N also. N indicates number of years, T indicates time. Most probably T or N both is in years. It is like 5 years, 7 years, 1 years. T always comes in years. Let's solve one example. Sandeep Bhau borrowed rupees 120,000 from a bank for 4 years at the rate of 8.5 PCPA for his son's education. So there is one person whose name is Sandeep Bhau and he has taken a loan from bank of rupees 120,000 for how many years? 4 years, okay, at the rate of 8.5 PCPA. 8.5 we can also write as 8.5 for his son's education. What is the total amount he returned to the bank at the end of that period? Now we are asked to find out the amount, okay, total amount at the end of that period. Which period? 4 years. We have to remember that thing, not 1 year. We cannot use 1 year now. We have to find out the interest and the amount for 4 years. We'll solve it with the help of the example formula. I is equal to P multiplied by T multiplied by R upon 100. Okay, solution. Principal is given rupees 120,000. The amount which we borrow from the bank or the amount which we save in the bank is called as the principal. So here in this example, principal is rupees 120,000. Okay, R is equal to 8.5. 8.5 is also written as 8.5. Time T is equal to 4 years. Therefore, interest is equal to PRT upon 100. Multiplication of P is 120,000 multiplied by 8.5 multiplied by 4 upon 100. This is equal to 120,000 multiplied by 85 into 4 upon 100 into 10. Now why 10 is added to the denominator? Why not in numerator? You may have a question. See, in the upper step it is 8.5 when multiplied with 10 becomes 85. So there it is directly written 85 instead of 8.5 multiplied by 10. So there you have to keep it in mind. Okay, so 120,000 multiplied with 85 multiplied with 4 upon 100 into 10. Denominator has total 3 zeros now, numerator has total 4 zeros. So we will cut out 3 zeros from numerator and denominators. Remaining part is 120 multiplied by 85 into 4. So final answer is 40800. It is 40,800 rupees. Okay, so what is this amount? This what we have found now, 40,800 rupees is the interest. We are asked to find out the amount to be paid after 4 years, right? So amount is equal to principal plus interest. What is the principal? 120,000. Amount is equal to 120,000 plus interest 40,800 rupees is equal to 160,800 rupees. Thank you.